Yo, what it do, SRT gang? It's your boy with the fat Swaggy Reacts, and we are back with another reaction video, man. And yo, it's midnight, and it's scary hour, and y'all know what time it is. Shouts out to Chills. He literally just dropped this, so I got y'all, man. He literally just dropped this, yo. Like, we about to get into 12 scary videos only for the brave among us, which is us, of course. And I was saying, plus we do this every night anyway, so y'all already know. Like, you guys checking this video for the first time, I drop one of these every night at midnight, man. So like, if you guys like scary reactions, man, hit that subscribe button, man, because I drop them every night at 12 or whatever. So without further ado, I'm not even gonna hold y'all up, man. Let's get into this. I'm excited, bro. He literally just dropped this like an hour ago, so let's get it. Let's rock.
This scary top 12 list shows mind-bendingly terrifying situations, and only the brave can handle watching them. Number 12. A stranger in Phoenix, Arizona.
Hold up, but it's supposed to... Oh no, it's 12. I thought it was top 10. It's 12.
Waits outside patiently for someone to leave so that he can gain access to an apartment complex he does not live in. He soon targets a random woman and follows her onto an elevator, getting off on the same floor. Moments later, he is running from her unseen friends after allegedly trying to advance upon her in the hall.
Oh, he switches. Man. See, man, we gotta worry about weirdos like this, like in your neighborhoods. If you live like in apartment complexes and stuff like that, like that with, you know, elevators or like staircases, or like, you know, like some apartments, you gotta park in like a garage where you gotta walk up, get on elevators. Be careful, man, because there's a lot of weirdos out here, man, because like they clearly like are single and been single forever and like don't know how to properly approach a woman. You know what I'm saying? So they pretty much gotta be weirdos like this guy. Like, come on, man. Come on, man.
After allegedly trying to advance upon her in the hall, he switches into a new pair of clothes on the way down so that police won't be able to track him based on what witnesses said he was wearing. Little does he know that a camera is watching his every move, including his new outfit. He gets away this time and probably will try to do something like this again. He seems well practiced and probably sees this as a game instead of thinking about the psychological damage he caused that night and how that poor woman must feel after going through something like this. Number 11.
Oh my, look at him.
Oh!
This is a really humorous.
Yo, you been us make a set. I don't know if it's gonna bite or what, like. You better not move, bro.
It's a random situation, but let's face it. If a wild seabird were to land on you, I don't think many of us would be able to take it with a smile like this brave cameraman does. He makes no sudden movements, not wanting to attract the bird's hungry gaze or its beak to his fingers. Believe it or not, I looked up pelican-human encounters and found out that the sides of its beak are razor sharp, so this situation could have actually gone wrong quick. I don't know whether this pelican wanted to take some of his fingers or take a rest, but it seems to realize it's outnumbered and takes off. Number 10. A ghost hunting crew named Full Moon Inc. Paranormal Investigators are certain they've caught some paranormal activity surrounding a cursed mirror recently purchased at a yard sale. Here's their evidence. A ghost does seem to unclasp the lock. The only way to fake this is with a string, which would be fairly easy to detect at close range, especially against the dark wood.
Yeah, I don't see no string. Like, that looks crazy though, bro. Like, I mean, how do you really explain that? Know what I'm saying? Like, that's some real shit it looked like.
Within a month, the ghost seems to have spread from the haunted mirror and into the kids' room. The Full Moon Inc. investigators are shocked to see a stuffed animal moving on its own. They suspect the toy is haunted by a ghost trying to play with them. The toy on top barely moves. Was the object moved by a ghost or by one of the paranormal investigators hiding behind?
I don't know, because like, why would all of a sudden a camera just be right there? You know what I'm saying? So I kind of feel like maybe it could be a hoax, like maybe someone could be laying on the other side or something, like in the back and or something. Like, I don't know, man.
The object moved by a ghost or by one of the paranormal investigators hiding behind.
Right.
Both incidents look real, but let's get your opinion on these paranormal encounters. Number 9. The Old South Pittsburgh Hospital in Tennessee is one of the most haunted hospitals on Earth. So much so that it's been officially designated as a paranormal research center on Google. Almost everyone that goes there has a paranormal experience. Take a YouTube channel called Lost Souls Paranormal, for example. One of the few research teams brave enough to go exploring the haunted hospital's basement, an investigator named Bailey splits from the group, and this is what he records underground.
Somebody running, right? It definitely sounds like somebody running, right? Yeah.
Running footsteps are coming from all directions and are possibly even in the same room that he is. Suddenly, the idea of ghost hunting isn't as fun as it was 5 minutes ago, and so he doesn't go any further. This is enough paranormal evidence to convince me, but let me know if you think it was his friends making the noise. Years prior, another paranormal investigator named L.W. Drums was close to the same spot of the hospital and experienced strange ghost activity as well.
Come on now, you're being really boring with us.
The voice of somebody who isn't there mocks the investigator with an exaggerated sigh, and a shadow appears at around this time too.
Come on now, you're being really boring with us.
Whoa. I mean, could that have possibly been like somebody that he's there with? Because you said you're boring us, like, could have been someone that he was possibly there with, maybe. Whoa, see? See what I'm saying? I think that was somebody. That's somebody that's with him, bro. They gotta be. Oh, man.
Something just touched my head.
Oh, something just touched you.
Ooh.
Something jabs him from behind. When he turns around, the mysterious camera goes out of focus like something is right up on the lens, and I don't know if this is a third member of the team, but at 29 seconds, a mysterious figure is definitely just sitting on the other side of the room staring at them. Number 8. Chris Hopkins goes exploring a haunted mental asylum close to 3 a.m. called Forest Haven. As the name implies, they have to cut through a forest on foot to get there, and that's when their troubles begin.
That was somebody.
Yeah. We're walking down the trail. We just heard someone right over there.
Chris turns on his flashlight and soon sees a mysterious light in return. They play flashlight tag for a while until they discover a group of other people who, while friendly, claim to be ghost hunters on a quote-unquote another mission.
Yo, we just met up with these guys.
Hey!
Yo, these were some of the guys we were bringing here.
Actual ghost hunters, but we're on another mission right now.
They don't think much of the comment and join together to go exploring the abandoned mental hospital. As they get to talking, the strangers kneel down and show what their special mission really is, to take copper from wires and sell it for money. That's when it occurs to them that they are around some shady people in an abandoned building who have sharp instruments and are looking for valuable equipment, like their expensive cameras. Thinking fast, Chris walks back to get his friends.
Dude, come out here and listen to all these birds. Listen to all these birds.
They don't say a word and awkwardly walk away, which is the right choice. Who knows what would have happened to them if they stayed around.
Exactly, because you never know, like, if those guys had guns or anything like that, could have just robbed y'all right then and there. But for y'all to just go ahead and get away from them is smart, know what I'm saying? Because, Like they were there to steal stuff to make money, or whatever. Like they know cameras worth a lot of money, so.
Number 7. A man is quietly fishing by himself, making content for his fishing channel called East Coast Fishing Adventures, completely unaware that he is being watched from afar. Partially concealed in the leaves is a person who is not with him and doesn't have a fishing rod. They just sit on a rock and don't move at all, just watching. The uploader gets the feeling that this is a ghost sighting, and it makes me wonder if he's sitting at the spot where somebody went under and sadly never resurfaced. Number 6. A father and son are bonding outdoors when they make a discovery in a puddle that's so bizarre they have to bring it home and make a video of what they've caught on camera.
So I kind of looked at the little creatures that were in there, and at my first glance they're round and have a tail just like a tadpole.
The mysterious creatures have a long tail and two eyes that are especially visible at 1 minute and 22 seconds. Baby horseshoe crabs were my guess, but when I googled a picture it looked different. So what do you think they are? Number 5. A group of friends loudly proclaim their disbelief as a slow moving object flies across Los Angeles.
Hey, it's from a different dimension.
Bro, like this is like the third video in a row that I've seen something like this, just like walking across in the air. Like, what is up with these videos, bro?
It's from a different dimension, like one of them jokes. But according to the uploader's own words, they felt a strange energy overwhelm them as the objects passed overhead. The object is really large to be that size. From such a far distance away, it's too big to be a commercial airliner, not to mention perfectly round and solid black. They are able to track it for over 2 minutes as it grows smaller on the horizon, and just before they can no longer see a thing, it blinks out of existence in a mysterious flash of light. The odd sighting in the sky occurred on October 4th of 2020, and is yet to be properly explained. The uploader says this was from another world, and it looks like he might be right. Number 4. Jackal365 goes exploring his old creepy attic the day after hearing scary noises all night. 1 minute and 55 seconds is when something is caught moving on camera. He reaches the back of the attic and strains his eyes in the darkness to see it.
I can't really see nothing.
See anything?
Can y'all see anything? Cause I can't see nothing right now. I can't see nothing.
Darkness to see it.
See anything?
A face drops down in front of the camera. Apparently the creature was hanging above.
Yo, what the fuck? Yo, I was not expecting that, bro. Oh my god. Yo, I was looking back there, because he said back there, I was like, oh, okay. You know what I'm saying? I was looking back there. Just, nah, hell no.
Hey.
A face drops down in front of the camera. Apparently the creature was hanging above him the whole time. He could have simply held a mannequin head upside down in front of the camera to create that effect, but his terrified squeal says otherwise.
Right.
Number 3. Junior Tour 1 helps his father move a table, and only when they put it down does he notice something he wished.
You see how big that damn spider was, boy?
Number 3. Ooh. Junior Tour 1 helps his father move a table and
boy!
Only when they put it down does he notice something he wishes he never caught on camera.
And we picked it up under here and we carried it out, and when I flipped it over, guess what I discovered? And I stuck my hands under there.
From the view at 36 seconds, it's easy to see how the spider stayed hidden from view. The circled area is where the spider is, and also exactly where he grabbed the table to lift it. For better context, this is where his fingers were. And of course, you already know where the spider is. He thinks this is a wolf spider, but someone else claims this to be a dark fishing spider. This is a fierce debate in the comments section of the video, so let's see if we can settle the issue here. Number 2.
But it's making my skin crawl now, like, I gotta check on my stuff, man. I gotta check, man, I don't got time, bro.
Two.
Okay, there is actually no wind.
Scary noises are coming from the end of a dark alleyway. Scary noises that sound more like a creature than a human.
I don't want to go down.
You've got night vision. You go down.
Night vision.
You just press the button on the side of the camera. Mm-hmm.
Oh my! Did someone's telly?
He turns on the night vision just in time to catch the flash of two large eyes the size of dinner plates and maybe 7 or 8 feet from the ground. They call out into the darkness and are greeted by a snarling creature that is finally caught on video. First, the eyes are visible once more at 1 minute and 17 seconds, moments before it comes at them, and right before they drop the camera to run, there is a blur of a mysterious creature on all fours running them down.
Yo!
I got a challenge.
Yo, I don't got time, bro. Yo, they got to chill with this shit, guys.
Number 1. This creepy picture has been freaking out the internet in recent months. A man in all white stands motionless on the other side of a fence in the forest, hands at his sides, and there's something about his eerie eyes, or lack thereof, that made people feel extra uneasy.
Bro, what is wrong with
looking for a source of his picture, because I've seen it featured on other channels, and I finally discovered where this photo is from. This is actually a still frame taken from a popular television series called Doctor Who. The character is called The Watcher. This photo is commonly shared in the Spanish-speaking countdown community, and maybe those YouTubers aren't aware of the show. So if you've ever seen this photo on a different list, now you know where it's from.
Wow. Most people. Well, I've never seen that photo. Well, that's the first time I've seen that. Wow, that's crazy though, man. Shouts out to Chills, man, for giving us that banger for us. He saved us tonight, because I didn't know what I was going to react to, man. I'm telling y'all, man, and I appreciate you guys checking this video out. Hit that like button, man. Hit that subscribe button if you're new, man, because I drop one of these every night at midnight. And again, I'll be back tomorrow with another one at midnight, so make sure you guys hit that subscribe button, hit that bell so you don't miss it. It's SRT Gang. I'm out this thing, man. Let's get it.